Hi, I'm Nathan Seidel with SparkFun Electronics, and I've got a really exciting announcement today. We've been doing high-precision GNSS location services using the RTK Surveyor and RTK Express line of products. It looks kind of like this when it's all set up. And for the last 5 or 6 months, we've been working to sort of mash all of these bits together into one unit. So, through the magic of television and through a little custom injection molding, I present to you today the RTK Facet. So today I'm going to be talking to two slightly different audiences, the first being the GNSS surveying community and the second being the hardened embedded engineer. We're going to talk about it all. So for the GNSS surveyor, the RTK Facet is a location product. It'll connect to all your GIS apps over Bluetooth, and it gives you accuracy of 14 millimeters in a full RTK fixed mode in X, Y, and Z. The RTK Facet is capable of recording raw X and SFRBX data directly to a micro SD card. So for things like post-processing or doing research or doing some really incredible timing applications, the RTK Facet supports all of those advanced features. For the embedded crowd, let's talk a little bit about the technology inside. So the RTK Facet is based on the uBlox module that we've been using for years, the ZF9P, along with an ESP32 module. So those two pieces of technology give us the high-precision GNSS location data as well as the ability to broadcast that over Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. So let's open it up and have a look inside. Inside the RTK Facet, we've got a series of sub-assemblies, batteries, displays, and all sorts of fun stuff. So first, we're gonna start with the enclosure. So we decided to go with sort of an homage to the foothills here in Boulder. We wanted to look a little bit different from all the other UFO sort of surveying products and also give you a better grip overall. On top of this custom enclosure, we've got this black sock that gives you extra dust and water protection as well as some impact protection if it ever gets dropped. So inside the custom injection molding, we have a series of sub-assemblies. Here we have three different boards. Quite simply, we have the connector board, what we call the SD and the display board, and the main board that houses the ZF9P and the ESP32. Here you can see the FPCs, or flat printed circuit ribbons, FPC ribbons, interconnecting the boards and allowing us to communicate SPI and I2C and power and all sorts of things over those buses. It's been a ton of fun to design. Lastly, we have a rather large antenna element. So this is what drives the overall size of these products that you see in front of you. This is a really nice dual L1, L2 frequency antenna that allows us to get that really good precision. So walking around town with your cell phone, you're likely to see 2-3 meter accuracy at best with the GPS built into your phone. Walking around town with this, I'm seeing 15 to 20 centimeters off the shelf. That's a fraction of what you would normally see, higher precision than you would with an off-the-shelf GPS. Now, once you go into full RTK fixed mode using RTCM corrections, you can get down to 14 millimeters, also known as about half an inch, in X, Y, and Z. That's incredible. So it takes a bit of work to make it all happen, but the RTK Facet is a really powerful high-precision GNSS receiver for all of your location surveying and research needs. So let's head out in the field and see what it looks like in real life. Here we are out in the field. The RTK Facet was designed to give you some preliminary information about what's going on using the display. So currently we can see about a quarter of a meter of horizontal positional accuracy. So that's pretty good considering we don't have any kind of corrections and it's about an order of magnitude better than what you'd see from a normal GPS or GNSS receiver. In addition, it shows us that we've got about 25 satellites that are currently in view that we're using for our current fix. Next step, we're gonna connect SW Maps, which is the free Android app that we recommend using. You can use whatever GIS app you want, but SW Maps tends to work really well and provides us with everything that we need. So with SW Maps, we're gonna continue the project we were working on before. And now we need to connect to the facet that we've got in our hand today. It's MAC address 37E2. We're gonna connect to that. And immediately we've got our lat long, elevation, and fixed type. So everything looks pretty good. We can even go in and see some of the sky plots and the GNSS status. Currently our, let's see, horizontal accuracy is 184 millimeter. That's really pretty good. Yeah, way less than that quarter meter we were looking at before. We're currently recording all of our data to the cell phone over Bluetooth, as well as the micro SD card in the unit. Now, what we're gonna do is go in and turn on the Ntrip client so that we can get RTCM corrections over the cellular network. So when we hit connect, we're gonna connect to the SparkFun base station and start to receive those correction values. At the same time, let's go have a look at our GNSS status. And you can see we've already dropped down into RTK fix and we're at 14 millimeters. So what does that look like in real life? So let's go find ourselves on the map. Here we are standing out in the parking lot in front of SparkFun. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna rock the unit north. We're gonna see, we see a little dot move a little bit just by rocking it back and forth. So that is what you get. With normal GPS, you can tell what street you're on. With high precision GNSS, you can see what gum you're standing on. So that's the RTK Facet, newly released at SparkFun, something I'm really proud of. So consider checking it out for your next GNSS research project. And then give me 1 second while I try to remember how to make this thing stop recording. Boop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doo. I have to think about my units.
Sure.
Yep. Is that okay? Cool. So what's a good outro?